Today we're going to be taking a look at the EcoFlow Delta 3 Plus Portable Power Station. If you don't know what a portable power station is, it's an all-in-one battery, charger, inverter and DC power supply in a compact and portable package. They're great for taking care of your power needs on days out at work sites in the event of a power outage or on camping trips. EcoFlow have sent me the Delta 3 Plus to try out and share with you, so let's get it unboxed and we'll then take a look at what it has to offer. In the box we've got the Delta 3 Plus, a quick start guide and three cables. A mains power cable, a car charger cable and a barrel jack cable. Unlike some other power stations, the AC charger is built in, so you don't need to carry a charging brick along too. You don't need any more than just the power station and a cable or two to connect it up. Inside the Delta 3 Plus is a 1024 watt hour lithium iron phosphate battery, which is good for over 4000 power cycles. So if you use the full battery capacity every day, it would last almost 10 years, and you'd still have 80% of the original capacity. The battery is also protected by a three-layer system. The first is an IP65 battery enclosure, which protects it against dust and splashes. The second is a smart battery management system that provides real-time monitoring and regulation. And the last is a thermal runaway and fire propagation protection layer. The battery is also expandable up to 5 kWh by adding compatible battery packs through the battery port at the back. The Delta 3 Plus measures 398 × 202 × 284 mm for a total volume of 22.6 litres. This makes it really compact for the features and battery capacity that it includes. It's about 5% smaller than the previous generation Delta 2 and packs in more powerful charging options. It's also relatively lightweight at 12.5 kilograms. To charge the Delta 3 Plus up, you've got a couple of DC and AC options, and they're all under this newly designed cover on the back. Using the built-in mains charger, you can charge the EcoFlow Delta 3 Plus at up to 1500 watts. This will take it up to 80% charged in under 40 minutes, and fully charged in under an hour. This is something that was previously only available on their River series. So even if you've forgotten to charge up your power station the day before your trip, you should still have enough time to charge it up while you prepare your things before heading out. It has dual 500 watt MPPT charge controllers for up to 1000 watts of solar charging power. This will take the Delta 3 Plus up to 80% in under an hour, which is better than most units this size. The Delta 3 Plus doesn't come with a solar charging cable, so you'll need to buy that separately. These DC ports can handle up to 800 watts from your vehicle's alternator to charge it up while you drive. Using the alternator input, you can have the power station fully charged in a 2-hour drive. You can also do a combination of charging inputs up to a total of 1500 watts. So if you have 1000 watts of solar input, you can increase the total charging input to 1500 watts by adding 500 watts of mains power too. The cover on the back also stows away into the unit to get it out of the way. To keep the battery and inverter cool, there are some vents and a cooling fan at the top of the Delta 3 Plus. The fan isn't always on though, it's PWM controlled and only comes on under higher loads, particularly when charging on mains or when supplying a high AC load, so it shouldn't be very audible most of the time. To use the stored power, the Delta 3 Plus has a range of ports and outlets. The four AC outlets are powered by a 1800 watt pure sine wave inverter, which can handle a surge of up to 3600 watts. Like with some other EcoFlow products, using their X-Boost technology, it can power some devices up to 2600 watts continuously. We'll take a look at this a bit later in the video. Above the AC outlets, it's also got four USB ports. These are two USB Type-A ports that can do fast charging up to 36 watts, and two USB Type-C ports that can do power delivery up to 140 watts. On the back under the charging ports, it's also got three DC outlets. It's got one car power outlet which can do 12 volts at up to 10 amps, and two barrel jack outlets which can also do 12 volts but up to 3 amps. The display on the front of the Delta 3 Plus is similar to other EcoFlow models. On the left it shows you the total power input or charging power in watts. In the center is the battery capacity with a power draw animation ring, on the right is the total power draw in watts, and at the top is the time to fully charged or empty, depending on whether the battery is being charged or drained. There are also other small indicator icons that come up when certain settings are activated. The display goes to sleep automatically after 5 minutes by default, but it can be woken up again by pressing the power button. You can also change the sleep duration in the app. Above the display are three buttons. The center one turns power on or off and puts the display into sleep or wake mode. The left and right button turn the AC and USB supplies on or off respectively. The button for the DC supply is at the back above the DC ports. Now that we've had a look at some of the features on the Delta 3 Plus, let's try to do some tests on it. It has currently got a 30% charge, so let's get it drained completely and we can then test whether we can achieve an 80% charge in 40 minutes and a full charge in under an hour. I'm going to hook up a small 1800 watt fan heater to drain it completely. The Delta 3 Plus stops the AC outlet when the battery is depleted. This prevents over-discharge, but the battery management system and display remain active a while longer. Next, I connected it up to a main supply and timed how long it took to charge to 100% capacity. After a few seconds, the display indicated that it would be fully charged in 1 hour. I checked in at 15 minutes and the battery was 33% charged. The display indicated another 35 minutes remaining, so it was on track to complete the charge in under an hour. After 40 minutes, the battery was at 77%, and after an hour it was at 94%. It was fully charged in 1 hour and 8 minutes, so a bit short of under an hour as claimed, but it's worth noting that this was in a workshop in summer in Australia, so the ambient temperature is around 29 degrees. A big part of fast charging a battery is keeping it cool, so if the ambient temperature is lower, you'll be able to charge it faster. Now let's plug some devices into it to test the AC supply. I've already shown the Delta 3 Plus powering a 1800 watt heater, but you couldn't hear the Delta's fans over the sound of the heater. So if I move the heater to another room and use an extension, we can see how quietly it runs. At full load, the fan ramps up almost immediately, but it still is fairly quiet. It stays at around 48 decibels, right within 10 centimeters. Next, I'm going to try run my two 3D printers to print a vortex cube. These each draw about 500 watts when heating up, and they settle on an average under 100 watts once printing. They ran for about half an hour to print both cube components, and at the end the Delta 3 Plus was at 71% capacity. As I said earlier, the Delta 3 Plus is equipped with a 1800 watt inverter, but using EcoFlow's X-Boost technology, they claim that you can run most appliances up to 2600 watts without overloading it. So I'm going to try power this electric barbecue that draws a little over 2200 watts. So it looks like the Delta 3 Plus is able to power the barbecue when it's turned all the way up, but you'll notice that the power output is still only around 1800 watts. X-Boost is able to power the barbecue on the highest setting by still only outputting the inverter's maximum continuous power. It does this by intelligently reducing the output voltage so that the inverter is not being overloaded, but it still is powering the device. Now obviously this is going to lead to a slight reduction in performance of the appliance, but it does at least still give you a way to use it. There are some limitations with X-Boost. Because it's lowering the output voltage, which is common to all outlets, you can't use it if you've got multiple devices connected to it. If this is something you don't want to use, you can turn off X-Boost in the settings menu in the app. It's off by default. One of the features I'm most interested in is the UPS functionality. My 3D printers and desktop milling machine often run for long periods of time. A single short power interruption can cause fail prints or projects, so I'd like to put the Delta 3 Plus in line with their main supply so that they're kept powered through any interruptions. The UPS on the Delta 3 Plus has a 10 millisecond changeover time, which is really fast for these style power stations. Most others have an advertised 20 to 30 millisecond changeover time, so this is 2 to 3 times faster. So I've got both 3D printers running on the AC outlets. I've used an adapter because both printers' power cables are quite short. There are two important metrics to look at here. The first is the transfer or changeover time of the UPS, which in this case should be under 10 milliseconds. And the second is the hold time of the device being powered. Because most electronic devices have power supplies with capacitors in them, they can usually handle a total power loss for a couple of milliseconds without the device turning off. So let's pull out the main supply and see whether the printers notice it. So both of the printers are still running with the mains power now turned off, and they didn't seem to mind the interruption. When the power comes back on, the Delta 3 Plus changes back over to the main supply. I also connected an oscilloscope to the AC output so we can visualize the interruption to the sine wave and see what the transfer time is. The interruption shows up nice and clearly. We have 10 millisecond divisions, and the flat line starts a tiny bit after the division starts, and the sine wave starts again where the division ends, so the transfer time is a tiny bit faster than 10 milliseconds. Another nice feature if you're going to be using it as a UPS long term is to limit the maximum and minimum depth of charge. This can also be done through the app. Limiting the charge depth improves the longevity of the battery, as you aren't putting as much strain on it for each cycle. As I've shown a couple of times already, you can connect the Delta 3 Plus up to your smartphone through Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. This allows you to monitor and control it, as well as change its settings. From the main screen, you can see the time remaining to fully charged or emptied, depending on how the battery is being used. You can also see the current rates of charge and discharge in watts for each individual port. You can turn the AC or DC inputs and outputs on and off remotely through the app as well. You can also access the device settings, which allows you to do things like turn X-Boost on and off, set timeouts, manage charge and discharge levels, and even reduce the maximum power that the power station can draw from mains when charging. Overall, I'm really impressed by the Delta 3 Plus. Being a third generation product, it's well refined and has a good set of features. They've also made some nice ease of use adjustments over the original, like moving the outlets to the front, adding the cover over the ports at the back, and improving the charge rates. With the lithium iron phosphate battery, it should also last you 8 to 10 years even with moderate use. If you're in Australia, you can buy the EcoFlow Delta 3 Plus through their distribution partners like Anaconda, Total Tools, Autobahn, Harvey Norman, or online from Amazon, eBay, or the EcoFlow website, and it also comes with a 5-year warranty. Let me know what you think of the Delta 3 Plus in the comment section below, and if there's anything else you'd like to see me test on it. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.